Hi there, and welcome to another edition of Exactly at Home North of Pittsburgh. And today I have the pleasure of speaking with Jeff Patton, owner of Baseball Card Castle, right here in the center of Cranberry Township. So stay tuned to find out about the entire world of sports memorabilia and collectibles that you can find right here. Tell me, Jeff, what led you to get into this business?
I have to tell you, I've always loved sports. I've been around sports my whole life, and what a better way to make a living. Unless you can play in the NBA or the NHL or one of the major sports leagues, this is the next best thing. I get to talk about sports all day, every day with people. That's what I enjoy.
Wow, that's fantastic. And I see it's called Baseball Card Castle, but it's obviously way more than that.
It is. In the infancy of this hobby, baseball cards was a term that enveloped all sports. If you collected, you collected baseball cards, and then you may have collected football and basketball. Baseball is the granddaddy of them all, hence the name Baseball Card Castle. We predate the surge that has tentacles in all the sports. When we started this in the mid-1980s, it was primarily baseball. That's why we were Baseball Card Castle. But we enjoy all the sports equally. We have stuff from all the favorite teams.
That's fantastic. I mean, I certainly remember the days of the baseball cards. I collected them with the slab of bubble gum in there, and also like name them and trade them with your friends. I mean, that was the game, right?
It was, and one of the things that's interesting about how we got started was I literally never dreamed of making any money. That was the last thought I had. I enjoyed this stuff so much. When I was a teenager, I started to sell things so I could have more. I thought if I bought 10 of them and sold 8, I'd get 2. And then the next year, I thought if I bought 100 and sold 80, I'd get 20. Yeah. And then I realized I had to pay the rent.
Yeah. Well, how long have you been at this location, and what brought you to Cranberry Township?
We've been in Cranberry for 31 years. We've been in this building since 2003. We needed some more space. We originally were in Cranmar Plaza, and we moved here in 2003 because we needed more space.
Yeah, well, what do you like about being in Cranberry? I mean, this has always been a growing area, right?
It is. I grew up in Newcastle and went to school at Robert Morris. So, like, as a late teenager, making the trip south to school all the time, you go through Cranberry and think, man, this is a growing place. We were here before Walmart was here, right? Like, that was a field with grass 2 feet high.
That's right.
But you don't have to be a genius to figure out 1979 and the Turnpike intersect less than a mile from here. So even as a teenager, that was what drew us here.
Sure. And I imagine you have customers coming from quite a distance.
Well, and because of the easy proximity to any direction, because of the roadways, we do get customers from Erie, Edinburgh, Ohio, because you can come right across the Turnpike. It is one of the beauties of Cranberry.
Well, you know, I've been in the area for 30 years too, and I've watched the virtual explosion of Cranberry over that time. In fact, when I first moved here, they hadn't even finished Route 279.
Yeah, what opened this place up, for certain.
Well, I look around and I see helmets and jerseys. The jerseys, and I see framed jerseys and signed jerseys in people's houses. I mean, is that relatively new thing in collectibles?
It's not necessarily new for us. The vantage point of it's difficult to sell a 2.5 inch by 3.5 inch card on the top of your wall, so we started to carry things that were three-dimensional, larger items in order to make the atmosphere more attractive. And to be honest, back in the day there weren't that many different cards, and we had them all. So like, after you get them all, you go like, what else am I going to do with my space? One of the things that goes along with people that collect cards now is you hear the term a man cave. People want to decorate their basement or their television room with appropriate sports paraphernalia. That's what the intrigue is.
Now, are there some people that get into this as an investment, like a big historical game, you know, the signed ball of the game, baseball and football, I see.
Definitely, that's an aspect of it. One of the things I think is enjoyable, like if you buy silver, there's nothing against it, I buy silver, there's nothing against it, but you buy it, you put it in your safe, and it sits there, right? This stuff, not only can you enjoy it, but there may be a chance that it has value at the end of the day. So it's a double whammy. That's what's enjoyable about it to me.
That's fantastic. As we look around the store, can you describe like just some of the things that you offer here?
Well, it changes every day. Our main focus is cards. We have 15 million cards in this building.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, we have stuff that dates back to 100 years. Most of the foot traffic that comes through the door desires the new things. That's what's really intriguing about this hobby. If a player throws 5 touchdown passes on Sunday, on Monday, his cards will be desirable. So my job is to be organized and prepared where I can get to that stuff quickly. It doesn't do you any good to have 15 million cards if you can't find them. One of the things we're known for is people who are looking for a specific card come here knowing that we have a lot of choices. We also have 60,000 autographed items in the building.
Wow. So
that's an interesting aspect. All certified autographs so people know they're authentic.
Yeah.
And it's just an interesting thing. We like to sort of consider ourselves like curators of Pittsburgh sports.
Yeah. Well, as a curator, it's like, is there a network of people that deal in sports memorabilia and that sort of thing?
Yeah, I think it's a small community of everybody who's in this knows each other. I think whatever genre you're in, there's a networking process.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure of that.
Well, that relates into the real estate business as well. So, Jeff, tell me, what's one of your favorite aspects of this business?
The thing I enjoy the most is when families come in and you have a father and a son or a daughter or a mom and a son, and they look around and see things from 100 years of Pittsburgh sports, and there's nothing like Grandpa saying, you should have seen how great Mario Lemieux was. And then the kids' perspective is how great Sidney Crosby is, and listening to the dynamic, comparing eras, players, and having families integrate those conversations. That's my favorite part of this.
So I guess there's some unusual collectibles or some unusual things that people think are collectibles. Tell me about those.
Well, we get 200 people a week who come in to sell us cards or memorabilia, people that are moving and want to downsize, people that have collected things, or people that invested and think that their investment has matured. And we get, it's everything. We've gotten truck fulls that have come. We get box fulls that come. Sometimes a child moves out of the house to a different area and he says, get rid of my stuff. Sometimes people invested in things and it's became really valuable and they want to sell it for the money. We have the whole range and we've bought truckloads. We've bought box loads. We've gone to houses. We get almost 200 people a week who either call or come through the front door to bring us sports memorabilia.
That's fantastic. Well, I really appreciate you taking the time, Jeff, to tell us about your store. And for you people out there, if you like sports, if you want memorabilia to represent what you like about sports, there is a huge variety here. So you should come out and check out Baseball Card Castle right here on Route 19 in the center of Cranberry Township. So tune in again next time for another edition of Exactly at Home, north of Pittsburgh.
Thank you.
Thank you.